Hi guys, Brian here, and welcome to another commentary video. I wanted to talk today about flashlights, because I don't know. I've come to a weird position that I've never been in since like my very, very early days of Dead by Daylight in my Dead by Daylight career. You guys know, I play a lot more of a balanced ratio between how much I play Killer and Survivor. I still prefer Killer, but I definitely play a good mixture of both now. But I started out my career as a killer main. I played like 2,000-3,000 hours of killer before I started playing Survivor pretty evenly. So that's a lot of hours on killer. And I still primarily play killer. So 4,000 hours of the game, that's a lot. That's a lot of time that I'm never getting back. That's a little scary. But in a less bleak way, let's go ahead and talk about flashlights. Because when I first started playing the game, I detested flashlights, right? Flashlights were very, very annoying, and people would lurk around and hit them on me, and it would denies my whole hook, and I'm mad, and it feels like I'm getting a bully squatted. You've been there, and some of you are probably still there. But as you continue to play the game, it kind of starts making a little bit more sense. Is pick up at a weird time, walk over, don't pick them up right away. Walk a little bit left, then suddenly pick them up. That way they have to reposition out of nowhere, and then they miss the flashlight timing. They're like, yes, good. Down them near the wall, go near the wall, face the wall as you pick up, no angle. You can't get the angle on the flashlight save, and now the flashlight is gone. And then you start to realize over time, while you're baiting these saves, while you're facing a wall, while you're doing all this, that's one person, maybe two if two are going for the save, that aren't on a gen. So essentially you're wasting the time of a bunch of people, and they may not even get the save at the end of the day. Now, when you're first starting out, obviously you're I hate flashlights. I'm going to bring Franklin. I'm going to bring Lightborn. You do all this stuff because you don't know how to counter flashlights really well yet. You can even just chase the guy, right? If you know somebody's lurking around, you can just go chase that guy. There's nothing stopping you from just slugging that one person and going and chasing the other dude. Slugging is almost always a good play. Slugging can be done wrong, but a lot of times slugging is just honestly just a great play. It's just something good to do in the video game, right? So just leave that guy and go chase the other guy. There's plenty of ways that when you're a fledgling player, you're kind of afraid of flashlights. You start to realize the value in somebody just not being on a gen. Because time in DBD is gen time. I say that every video. And if somebody's just sitting there, crouched up behind a tree, waiting for the save, and they don't even get it at the end of the day. They don't even get the save after waiting that long. That was time not spent on a gen. And you start appreciating that more than seeing med kits in the lobby, seeing toolboxes in the lobby, stuff like that. You start preferring flashlights over that. And that's a real sign of growth as a killer player, to start enjoying seeing flashlights in your lobby instead of fearing them. And some of you aren't there yet, and that's okay. But trust me, that time does come. That time does come where you're like, oh, okay. This isn't the worst thing in the world. And I've always felt that way. But recently, at 4K hours, I'm like, you know what? Flashlights suck. I actually hate going against flashlights now. For the first time since I was a fledgling player in this game, since I was still learning, I actually hate flashlights in the game now. And it was kind of a weird change because of the things that I just described. You come to kind of enjoy flashlights as a killer because you're like, well, you're not on a gen. You're not slamming out the gens at mock speed. You're not bringing a stupid purple med kit and healing your friends in 2 seconds. You're actually trying to interact with me. And if you fail, that was a waste of time on your part, idiot, But if you don't know, flashlights got a recent change when the night dropped, where flashlight saves got removed from lockers. So you can't do locker flashlight saves anymore. But as a trade-off, flashlights got an extra window of buffer for their effectiveness. So I think it's 0.4 seconds, I believe, to be exact. It was 0.4 seconds. So now the window of opportunity, not the perk, the window of opportunity to get a flashlight save is extended. It is extended. I have had some of the most wild flashlight saves I have ever seen in my entire life happen since that update has happened. I kid you not, there was one flashlight save where they got the save when I picked the person up. If you don't know why that's weird, flashlight saves, you can be either early or you can be late. Right, you have to get the timing correctly, typically, on flashlight saves. It's not just flash the light, and as long as you get the blind, you call it a day, right? If you're too early, it doesn't count. If it's too late, it doesn't count. So you got to get that timing, in this middle zone, that's really nice. And that middle zone went from being kind of really, really narrow and very, very skill intensive to like being super wide and easy to achieve. So when I picked this person up, and while like my character's hand was like reaching down to pick up the survivor, that's when the flashlight went off. If you didn't know what the old timing was, the old timing used to be when the survivor's being like saddled onto your shoulder. You had to get the flashlight saved right here, right about their neck, right here, because that's where their face hitbox is for some reason. It's not up here, it's down here, around their chin and neck for whatever reason. And also, you had to get the timing right of, you know, when they picked them up onto your shoulder and not like, you know, any other time. It had to literally be while they were saddling you on the shoulder. Now, like that person got that save on me. Why was picking up the survivor? Why was literally picking up the survivor? Got the save. They were so early. So early. Didn't matter. Same thing on the other side. They can get saved super late. Doesn't matter. Essentially, that little window that they added to extend the flashlights have made them like really easy now. Because even when I would get flashlight saved, right? Like it's never a fun thing, right? Like I'm like, well, crap, right? Like I gotta restart that whole chase and down that guy and put him on hook. But like at least they did something skillful, right? Like at least they pulled it off, right? Like they were patient. They didn't fall for my mind games. You know, they got the timing. They got the positioning. Like they did everything right. Right? Now it's just kind of like there's nothing special about it anymore because it's so lenient. It's so lenient now that like you can mess up the flashlight all you want and like you will most likely still get the save. So like I don't know. Like even on the survivor side, you guys saw that like if you guys, you know, follow my Twitch, follow my TikTok, I beamer save sometimes. That was a fun thing for me for a little bit there. I don't even go for those anymore on the survivor side of things. Cause like the fun part, just like the same reason I play like Huntress and Billy and Destiny, you're like the thrill of flashlight saving is the precision for me. It is that it's something hard to pull off and it's something like hard to do. I don't bring beamers anymore. I don't remember the last time I brought a flashlight into a game because like literally like the thrill of it was that it was difficult to pull off. And now that difficulty's just gone. It's just so free now. And I know a lot of my survivor main friends feel the same way. There's like they feel really like a lot of my friends moved over to flashbang because that kind of still retains its difficulty because flashbangs were always really, really hard. So a lot of my friends moved over to flashbang when that first happened because, you know, that was their thrill of getting flashlight saves too, is like the difficulty of it. So a lot of them moved over to flashbang. But yeah, I've never hated flashlights, and that's because, you know, they are beneficial to me in terms of like gameplay, counterplay, people not on gens. But the first time in my DBD career, I actually kind of hate them because something that was skillful and an interesting part of the gameplay is now just kind of super lenient and kind of free. And the effect is still devastating, which is, you know, having somebody, you know, denying you a hook, right? So for something so devastating as denying you a hook in a game of killer, being lenient, it just feels bad. It just feels bad. And it's a change that they won't revert, but I really wish they would. Because it has made me hate this item for the first time, like, since I was a baby in the game. So, yeah. What do you guys feel about current flashlights? Do you think they're a little too lenient, or do you think they're fine the way they are? Let me know down in the comments below. But other than that, that's going to be it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, friends. I appreciate y'all. But, you know, I do upload daily, so I will see you in the tomorrow zone. But if I do not, well, you know. I'll see you when I see you. Goodbye.